So, I had a bit of a disaster the other day. I was doing my morning routine, get up, cigarette, make coffee, get ready to start mixing. And I came into my office, as I do every day, put the coffee down, and I went to lift the lid up on a laptop and slap the coffee straight inside my S3. And the first two faders are broken. Massive fail. So, today I'm going to show you two things. One, how to self-test and run the utility function on the S3 to find out which faders are busted. And two, how to replace them. Let's go and get on with it. Alright, so here is the afflicted S3. Now, to be able to get into utility mode, you're going to want to press over here the user and cancel buttons, and over here view 1 and view 2. Now you press all of these at the same time whilst powering it on. So that one, and then we go, where's view 1, view 2? Cool. And you hold these down until the Avid logo has disappeared. Here we go. Now you're into the utility menu. This is the utility menu. Now, when I did the initial damage, faders 1 and 2 were broken. However, I use 1 and 2 a lot more often than I use 15 and 16, so I actually switched them around. So at the moment, 15 and 16 are broken. But today we are going to replace 1 and 2 with new ones and put 15 and 16 back where they were, because the ones that I use the most often should probably be the brand new ones, because I'll get the most life out of them, or at least that's my thinking. Anyway, once you're in the utility menu, you want to go into fader. So you just press the rotary encoder, and then you can do group, sine wave. As you can see, this one's kind of working, and there is absolutely no life out of this one at all. It kind of works. It tries. This one is completely dead. Let's go back. If we then go to fader again, now we'll test the touch functionality. When you touch the fader, you'll notice the select channel light goes green. So yes for that one, yes, 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 that one, that one, that one, that one, that one, one, that one, that one, that one. And you'll notice these two have a red recording light problem. You touch them, nada, nothing. All these two, all the rest of them, sweet as a nut. They will all move together, no problem. All the LEDs are working. Now on these two, nothing. Completely dead. Awesome. Right, let's get around to changing them. Okay, you're going to need a couple of things. First things first, you're going to need some new S3 faders. I got these from Lee Engineering in the UK. I will put a link to their website in the channel description, in the video description. They are an Avid reseller. These cost me £50 UK each. If you're based in the States, I believe Vintage King sell them. You can also get them off Avid directly, but God only knows how much they're going to charge for them. I've seen them online at around about $100 each from various sources, but shop around, I'm sure you can get a deal. You're going to need a Phillips head screwdriver, decently smallish one. You're also going to need an Allen key. I have absolutely no idea what size this is, but I got it from a multi-tool kit, so it's fairly small, but get some Allen keys and you'll find one that fits. Right, first things first, pop the fader caps off. You can just do that literally by hand. They just slide on there. Put them to one side, two, and we're taking off the far side as well, which you can't see, but I'll pull them off. And you literally just put a little bit of gentle pressure on there and they come right off. Next, you want to get these two bolts on the top. One at the bottom and one towards the top. And you can just unscrew those in situ and you'll notice that the actual fader unit starts to become loose underneath. Now this is okay, you will not damage anything. So undo them. And I'm also going to do 15 and 16 at the other side. Alright, flip the unit over and you'll see this panel here. Now, around this panel, there are a bunch of Phillips head screws. We're going to take these bad boys off next. There isn't actually a lot of thread on them, so if I can hold this one up, because I do have a magnetic screwdriver. Focus. As you can see, they're very, very short screws, so they only take a couple of turns to get them out. Apart from two of the screws, which are this one, which are this one and this one. They are slightly longer. Let me take those out and I'll show you those. Why they are slightly longer, I do not know, but just make sure that you put them back in the right place. As you can see, they're a little bit longer than the rest. All right, they're out. So, you may actually need a flat blade screwdriver as well, or some sort of pry tool, because this is a bit of a bitch to get up. So I just tend to put a flat blade in there and just lever it to lift it, and that just lifts away. Now this gives you access to all the fader modules on the inside. As you can see, they're already loose where we've unscrewed them. So, if you think about the other side of the unit, these two on this side are the broken ones, and these two on the far side are the two good ones. So, let's take the busted ones out first. So all you do is you pull this cable so it's loose, and you just lift the fader unit up and out, and there you go. Put that to one side. Same again for this one, you just pry the cable away, lift out, done. Nice and lovely. So they can go back in here. So to put them back in, all you do is line it up, slide it in, that's what she said, and just push down nice and firm until you get a solid click on the connector. Again for the second. Line it up, push down, nice little click, there we go. Now, as for the new ones, let's take a look at them. I'll try my best to open them on camera. I'm told these are brand new, so hopefully. Jesus Christ. Brown tape is not my friend. Okay, let's pull this sucker out the packet. Voila! Certainly feels new. Looks good. Let's check it against the old one. Yep, that looks the same to me. Awesome. Right. Hang on a sec. Let me move you so you can get a better view. Alright, how about that? So, we're going motor to the top. Let's get that first one in, and that is going over and in here. Purple cable to the outside. Okay, that one's in. And let's just unbox the second one. Check it. Feels good. In with that one. Bend it over. Purple cable to the outside. Or should I say purple cable to the bottom, just judging by all the rest of them. Nice click. Awesome. Right. Next, we stick this back on. And we just lie that down as so. And you can go back in with your screws. Just finger tight. You don't have to get silly on them. There's no need to strip any of the threads. There's plenty of screws to hold this panel on, so I guess that's why they're short threaded. They're not going to go anywhere. Okay, so to tighten these screws back up, all we're going to do is just get hold of the actual fader and just pull it up ever so slightly. And as you're pulling it up, start to feel around and spin the screw. And you'll eventually feel it bite. So just pull the fader module. Get some bite on the screw. And there we go, that one's in. Same for the bottom. Okay. Now, once you've done that and they're both in, what you need to do is have a look at the fader cap. Now you'll notice one side has a thin end. The other side has a more rounded broad end. It goes thin end to the top. So you just line them up, push them down, done. And they fit on there nice and snug. Push them on, nice bit of pressure. Voila! Faders. Right, let's test it again and see if it works. Here we are back in test mode. And if I take you in a little closer, you will see not only the first two working, they're all working. So if we go back, and then we go to fader, and now, as you can see, we've got lights. All good. And the two busted ones. Lovely. If we zoom out. All working. Fixed. I thought I'd do the outro to this video stood up, because why not? This is why a lot of studios have a no drinks on the desk policy, because idiots like me slap coffee into faders and they're broken. However, this time I've managed to get away with it. Luckily there was no damage to the internal PCB, motherboard, all of that gear. It's all working fine. It cost me £100 for a pair of faders. Nice lesson learned. So that's how you fix an S3 with busted faders. Now, if you're not sure if you've got damage to the board inside, go into utility mode earlier in the video, and that will generally tell you if it's not receiving signal, or, you know, if the fader isn't moving. You'll be able to test all of that kind of thing. It'll tell you if the touch sensitivity is working, and it kind of gives you an idea. So I did that at first, and I realized that the fader modules were broken. So I switched them around to two that were known working, put them in the broken slots, and they started working fine, and the problem followed the broken ones. So I knew that it was just the fader modules that were broken, but the actual PCB was fine, because with working modules in, it worked absolutely normally. So I went ahead and ordered the replacement modules, and voila, we're back in the game. So, as I say, harsh lessons learnt, but I hope some of you who have an S3 out there and maybe run into this problem, notice that two things. One, thanks Avid for making them user replaceable and very easy. I mean, it takes me, what, 5 minutes to do? In the artist mix, whoo, forget about it. You had to take the board out like they were a nightmare to replace. These ones are super easy. However, they are a little bit difficult to get hold of unless you find someone who has them in stock. As I say, I'll link Lee Engineering below. If you're in the UK and you need Avid spare parts, give them guys a shout. I spoke to Daniel there, really helpful guy. Got on the phone with me, told me all about the self-test functionality and how to check it all out. Really nice guys. Give them a call if you need anything Avid, and I know they repair a bunch of other stuff as well, so check their website out. That's all from me today. Thanks for joining me, and I'll see you in the next video.